Hi everyone, Darren from DrayTek Australia and New Zealand. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to enable the WAN aggregation feature available in DrayTek routers. WAN aggregation allows multiple WAN connections, whether they're DSL, Ethernet, or even 4G or 5G, to be aggregated. This feature increases internet speed by utilising session-based load balancing, which is supported in DrayTek's dual-WAN and multi-WAN routers. In session-based load balancing, two or more WANs can be combined into one fat pipe. Session-based load balance utilises the session layer of the OSI model, so we can use any type of internet connection since it's independent of the physical connection. As long as the destination is the same, that is, the same server, the session will be routed through multiple WAN connections. Note that those WAN connections must be different. That means two or more accounts with the same ISP or different ISPs. You can't just plug the same modem into two or more WANs on the router and expect higher speeds. Here are the current routers that support WAN aggregation. Note that wireless models also support wireless WAN, where you can connect the router to a Wi-Fi hotspot. LTE models in the 2865, 2866 and 2927 series can connect to an LTE service with a SIM. Other models have USB ports to allow connection of a USB LTE modem. The Vigor 3912 supports up to 8 WANs, including 10 gigabit fiber and 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. WAN aggregation is great for businesses that need high internet speeds to provide enough bandwidth for users. There's nothing worse than watching a download moving at a snail's pace when you have a deadline to meet. Or if you run a hotel or cafe and offer Wi-Fi hotspots, internet capacity may be limited by the speeds available at your location. WAN aggregation can work around that by combining two slow internet connections into one faster one. Okay, before we dive into the configuration steps, I'll demonstrate WAN aggregation using two connections from different service providers. WAN 1 is connected via an Ethernet connection. WAN 5 is connected via 5G. Let's start by testing WAN 1 on its own, and off it goes. 91.94 megabits per second download, 94.57 megabits per second upload. Not bad. Now for WAN 5, the 5G connection. And we get 22.41 megabits per second download and 20.09 megabits per second upload. So when we configure session-based load balance to combine them together, we should see around 110 megabits per second download. Let's test that out. Here we go. And as predicted, we have 110.65 megabits per second download and 111.3 megabits per second upload. All right, so it works. Let's now go through how to configure the router. Note that we'll be using a DrayOS 4 router in this example. So after logging into the router, we can see down the bottom here on the dashboard that we have two WANs up and running. Now navigate to WAN General Setup. After making sure that the active mode for the WANs you want to combine are set to Always On and Load Balance is ticked, all you do is go down here to the drop-down menu for Load Balance Mode and change it from IP-based to Session-based. Then click OK and wait for the configuration to save. And that's it. That's all there is to it. Okay, thank you for watching. Please like or leave a comment and don't forget to subscribe. For more information about DrayTek products, please check out our website at www.draytek.com.au or send us an email to sales@draytek.com.au or give us a call on 02983888999.